Jason Clear Creek Farm, how are we doing tonight? We have a goat that's due today. She's not progressing. She's not even looking close to kidding. So what I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to induce her to have her kid. So we got a doe that's due to kid today. She don't look like she is going to kid tonight or even tomorrow. And we're going to be gone here in a couple days. So we want to make sure she kids before we leave for the day or a couple days and stuff in our case. So what I'm going to do is induce her. First thing that we're going to do is give her dexamethasone, which will take and make sure that the kids' lungs are all ready to come meet the world. I'm not a vet. This is only our protocol that we take and run through our own vet. So you should consult your own vet to make sure this is what they would recommend you to do. So I'll give her 5 cc's of dexamethasone tonight, and then within 6 to 12 hours and stuff, we'll end up going and giving her 2 cc's of luteolase, which will start her into the process of kidding. And after you give her the luteolase and stuff, it'll take anywhere from 12 to 24 to 48 hours for her to start progressing and have the kid. So I'm gonna go over here to the other barn. I'm gonna get her moved around where she needs to be, and I'm gonna give her this shot of the dexamethasone. So I got the goat here. This is the dexamethasone. It's 5 cc's. I'm gonna give it to her sub-Q, which is just under the skin. Like I said, I'm not a vet, so consult your vet before you take my advice and to do this. Like I said, this dexamethasone will actually help make sure the lungs of the kids are developed and make sure that they don't have any problems if they're early. She should have kidded today, so I don't think we'll have any of that problem, but we like to use it as an extra securement. I don't know how good you can see this, but if you can tell there, her her bag's getting pretty tight here, so you know she's ready, getting close to kidding out. I'm gonna run over, I'm gonna get her a fresh bucket of water. This bucket here is empty. So I'm gonna get her a fresh bucket of water, get her some hay for the night. We already have a heat lamp set up if she decides to kid tonight, and I'll take and move one of our video cameras over here so that way we can monitor her from inside the house tonight and until she kids. Back up. But I'm gonna get this camera set up over here so that way we can monitor from inside the house. So I'm gonna use my phone, check this, make sure that it's good, and then we should be able to monitor her from inside the house. I'll come, like I said, I'll come back out in the morning and check her and give her the luteolacin, so that way she can start the process of having her kids. So it's the next morning, it's been about 12 hours now. I'm gonna give her 2 cc's of luteolacin. That should start the process of inducing her. The dexamethasone yesterday basically made sure that the lungs of the babies were developed or starting to develop, so when they're kid out, that they would be all right. This will be sub-Q as well, which means under the skin. So I hope this information about inducing a goat helps you along when you have a problem and you need to induce. Like I said, this ain't a regular practice for us. So we do this when we are gonna be gone or we're having problems with a doe kidding out. If she comes down sick, whatever else. So this is our protocol. Which is 5 cc's of dexamethasone, then 6 to 12 hours later, 2 cc's of luteolase to get her started. I'm not a vet, so consult your own vet before you end up using this protocol to make sure that's what they would do, because they are a vet. So hope this helped you guys. Have a great day and see y'all on the next video.